Hey everyone, well, I didn't get the ticket to London to go be with the Ravens and to watch them play at Wembley Stadium on Sunday, but I thought being in this room, which is my office, but really transformed into feeling like we were in England right now, and we feel we've pretty much narrowed England down into these six posters behind me. So we're basically there. I basically was given that task by my bosses, so we'll feel that way when we watch and listen to the Ravens game on Sunday when they play the Jaguars in London. I guess when you look at this game, the biggest factor is playing in London. The Jaguars have done this game now four times. This will be their fifth time playing at Wembley Stadium in London. For the Ravens, this is their first time traveling internationally as an organization, so everything that comes with that, the time change, perhaps the distractions of being there, a lot of family is there, the entire organization is basically in England with the Baltimore Ravens. So that is a factor, plus a venue change, everything from sight lines to the turf, the crowd, it's all a factor, and the Jaguars have been there before and the Ravens haven't. As for what's happening on the field, how will the Ravens deal with the loss of Marshall Yanda? And this won't just impact the Ravens facing Jacksonville on Sunday in London, this will impact them the rest of this season. You don't replace Marshall Yanda. He might be the best interior offensive lineman in football, and he's the heart and soul of the Ravens offensive line for a team that's already lost several offensive linemen this season. Losing Marshall Yanda is a huge factor. Now, can the Ravens get Mike Wallace the ball? That's been an issue. The team addressed that this week. Look for them to get Mike Wallace involved early. Defensively, can the Ravens keep it going? I imagine they will. Can they stop Leonard Fournette on the ground and force Blake Bortles into making mistakes? No one has been as magnificent as Ravens defense so far this year into stopping the opponent and forcing turnovers. Don't get used to five turnovers a game, but can it be two or three? And will that be enough? That's kind of the backdrop for this Ravens game. The backdrop is the backdrop. It's Buckingham Palace. It's 10 Downing Street. It's Big Ben. It's London. It's the Queen. It's the Spice Girls. It's Downton Abbey. It's the Crown. Or am I just naming modern day series on television? There's a new Churchill movie coming out, by the way, which I'm very excited about. And my dog is named Churchill, so I really should have been sent by that standard alone to London. But we're excited about the game on Sunday. Ravens and Jags. It has that London feel to it. Dare I say, we'll travel across the pond starting at 6 a.m. on Sunday morning for our Ravens coverage and the broadcast on WBAL. Kickoff is set for 9:30. Set the alarm and enjoy the game on Sunday.